The hyoid bone, it is a U-shaped bone. It is a visceral bone developing from the second and third pharyngeal arches and lies opposite the third cervical vertebra. It has a body which has anterior and posterior surfaces and upper and lower borders. At the junction of body and greater cornua is a small lesser cornua, which is small and pointing upwards. The body continues as the greater cornua, one on each side. The greater cornua has two surfaces and two borders. Attached to the hyoid bone are numerous muscles. Onto the body is a small part of the genioglossus muscle, which is a muscle of tongue. Next is the geniohyoid. Below that is the myelohyoid. This is a muscle of first branchial arch. Still below that are the strap muscles, the sternohyoid, the superior belly of omohyoid and thyrohyoid. These are strap muscles. Then on to the greater cornu is the middle constrictor muscle, and inferior to that is a big hyoglossus muscle, which is a muscle of the tongue. Attached to the lesser tubercle is the stylohyoid ligament, which is from the second pharyngeal arch, and there is a digastric pulley and the two attachments of the stylohyoid muscle. In addition, it gives attachment to the investing layer of cervical fascia, the pretracheal fascia and the digastric pulley, which has been mentioned. The figure shows the digastric pulley, which is keeping the two heads of the digastric, the anterior belly of digastric and the posterior belly of digastric, in position. The anterior belly of digastric is a muscle of first arch and the posterior belly of digastric is a muscle of second arch. So this is a composite muscle. Also seen in the figure is the facial artery lying at the anteroinferior angle of the masseter muscle, and it is palpable at the lower border of mandible, where it is known as the anesthetist's artery.